This Lion fan base have been craving home playoff football since this building opened in 2002, and they've got it today at Ford Field in Detroit. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the New York Giants and the Detroit Lions. One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Got a man. It's complete to Jelani Woods. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. They'll drop to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. First and 10 right at the 20. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Here's a second and 7. This pass caught, it's Woods. And the Lions are going to be set up with a first and goal here as the tackle made at the 9. Well, no question, this is exactly how they wanted to start this football game. And nice pass there. Now they're set up beautifully, Charles, to finish this off with a touchdown.
Yeah, but they've still got to finish it off, partner. And that means they've got to execute at this stage of the field. So we've seen many teams march it right to the goal line and not cash in. They've got something dialed up here that puts it in the end zone.
Expect this from the visiting team when playing indoors, but not the home team.
They're supposed to get all the advantages, right? The home crowd's supposed to help them. They forgot where they were, perhaps.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. couldn't hang on third down.
It hasn't been a real good start to this game from a defensive perspective, but now after the incompletion on second down, things may be changing. If they can come up with one more play, they might be able to get out of it with just a field goal attempt.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. And he's got it. 10 yards gets him closer, but now it's fourth and goal. They'll try and run for it. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Lions are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. Throwing to start the drive. Parsons. Wide open receiver complete. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. Operating from the gun. Parsons. And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there. Nearly an opening drive, INT. And he's got Rome. Touchdown, Giants.
Bottom line, when you play a runner with these talents, you've got to be able to wrap up and get him on the ground. Or the first person who gets there, hold him up long enough for the next wave to get there and get him down. Otherwise, he will continue downfield and find pay dirt.
They'll try and throw for it. And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack and a big sack at that. This remains a one-point game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening.
And this will be caught at the 30. And he'll be brought down at the 27. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, we keep stats on everything, don't we? This is one that you don't want to have. That's his second drop right here in the first quarter.
Yeah, I was going to say, only in the first quarter. Certainly a ship that he wants to right quickly. After the incompletion, here now, third and 2. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And brought down, but not before inside the 10 to the 7. Right back to him on first down. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown in this opening quarter as his guys are able to extend their lead. But he will not be able to advance this into the end zone, so it will stand as a blocked PAT. Well, not content with a first quarter lead, I guess. They're going to go onside kick. And this is going to be covered up by the Giants. So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely see the logic there.
It's not apparent, is it? You almost have to go deeper, I think, and maybe if we try and work along with them and speculate a little bit here, they must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game, and maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They've got to steal it and try and gain an advantage, and they tried. They just didn't get it done.
And now the throw here is incomplete, and with that, we come to the end of the first quarter of play. After one, it's 13-6. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Back to throw. Parsons over the middle into traffic, and that's complete. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
A dime look defensively for the Lions on 3rd. Now a handoff up the middle. Darby, and this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. He's able to work free for about 6 down to the 18.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry, and they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains.
Third down, Parsons. That's to Davis. He's got it. Touchdown, New York. A 20-yard touchdown. And the Giants are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. No luck going for 2 last time, so they'll just kick the extra point here. It's right through, and we are now tied at 13. All square now at 13 all as he sends this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
The offense coming back out here, plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
2nd and 13. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. Josh Allen from that outside linebacker spot gets in there. It's a loss of 9.
Let's go.
third and long. They'll look to throw. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. Call it a loss of two there on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Returnable here for Davis. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. Now a give, right side, Darby. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Throwing on first down, Parsons. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. 91 yards rushing for him now as he has been strong here in the first half of this divisional round matchup. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. From the gun on third down, Parsons. He rifles one that's intercepted. And the Lions are going to take possession here at their own 3-yard line. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And oh, he coughed it up! And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And this is taken into the end zone. A fumble recovery and a Giants touchdown. Even the great ones, some of the best, they're not immune to the fumble, and here it really hurts them.
If the ball gets away from any runner's body, that's when the defense pokes at it, swipes at it, swats at it, and finds a way to create a big play for themselves.
They had the big play on the fumble return. They were looking for the 1-2 punch, but they couldn't get that 2-point conversion.
And I have to wonder, were they scheduled to go ahead and kick the extra point? But after a play like that, you talk about the 1-2 punch, right? It's a momentum play. Go for two and really try to capitalize, and that's what they attempted.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that's caught at the 25. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash, this from an even 40 yards out. The kick by Sanders is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they've been the better of the two teams through two quarters of play, much to the chagrin of this home crowd.
Yeah, this score is a surprise to a lot of folks at home, although not to my dad. He predicted the visitors would win. And maybe to the folks in the stadium. But you know who is not a surprise to, partner? This team with the football. They were very confident coming in.
And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the four-yard pickup brings it to third down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Puts it on the carpet, it's out. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. And the aggressive play call simply does not work out. You're on your own side of the field here. Punt it, right?
Yeah, I would agree with that. There's a time for analytics and a time for being aggressive, but not with this field position. There's also a time for good old football 101 sets.
Yeah.
Punt it away. Let your defense take over with better field position.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Hands it off out of the gun. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. Second and 3 from the 9. And here's a handoff out of the gun. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll go to the air here on third and 2. And that is too far out in front of his intended target. Incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Now Jason Sanders for the field goal try. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Sanders' kick is good, and that will tie things now at 19-all. So they got the turnover, started with great field position, but in the end, the defense able to hold firm, and they only get 3 out of it.
And I like what you said right there, that defense able to hold firm, backed up into the shadow of their own end zone. The goalpost right behind them. They had to make sure they didn't give up the 6.
And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And good field position coming up here. The football at the 12-yard line.
And in our meeting with the special teams coordinator, we asked him, what's your philosophy on bringing the ball out? Do you give him a red light? Do you keep him in? Green light, let him go? Let's see if he changes from green light to red light after that costly error.
Yeah, you know what I remember from that meeting? He brought donuts.
I like him.
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah.
But he's not happy right now.
No, and don't tell everyone how many I had.
Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. On
third down, he'll drop to throw. And he'll go down, brought down at the 20-yard line. Josh Allen able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. Now Jason Sanders for the field goal try. This will be a 37-yard attempt. Sanders' kick is good, and they have regained the lead.
So his second field goal here in this third quarter.
The first one tied the game, and this one gets them the lead, but you just have to wonder if field goals are going to be enough. At some point, they've got to conclude these drives with the ball in the end zone.
Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right. Yeah,
throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And he's able to get up here to the 26. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. They'll run on first down. Darby, and he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. Joey Bosa, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. To throw on third down, Parsons. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Off play action, Parsons. Pressure comes and down he goes. Joey Bosa, his second sack of the night.
But defensively on the previous play, they gave up a pretty good chunk of yardage, but right there, they got a good portion of it right back.
And if we just flip it around from the offensive perspective, took a nice step forward, and how about a couple of leaps backwards after that play? They've got to figure out a big call coming up here to try and gain that yardage back.
And now another turnover as this one's intercepted.
And the Lions will take over here just shy of the 30.
Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
Second and six. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A gain of 28 yards there, and give him a first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Lions linemen might have moved. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. They'll set up to throw. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
They'll set up a throw. Looking left sideline, it's complete.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A big play there as they get the conversion on 3rd and 13. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, 2nd and 11. They're going to look to throw. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. Now, this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And the Giants will take over here at their own 14-yard line. Oh, my, how the tables have turned now. They were trying to salt this one away, but that interception, potentially a game changer.
And I've just got to think to myself, at this point of the game, I know you've been aggressive. I know that's your MO, and that's fine. And all those teams that talk about all gas, no brakes, you better have the emergency lever to pull occasionally. They could have used it right there. They put themselves in a tough spot with that interception.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Back to throw. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, now 3rd and 10. And first things first, before you think about marching the ball down the field, you got to move the chains.
You're exactly right. Got to get back into focus here. Get the first down. That's what's vital to them.
He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. Oh, that's going to be a costly one. It's intercepted. And the Lions are going to take possession of the football. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think, okay, he's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. As this complete to Woods. Touchdown! Jelani Woods. 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Lions are moving closer to a date now in the NFC Championship game as they're able to extend this fourth quarter lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. And the Lions are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line.
Okay, ready?
They'll look to throw here on first down. He's going to wind up and air it out. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. despite the lead here in the fourth, they're still taking shots.
Not content to sit on this lead at all. And to me, it raises the question of what's right in this game nowadays. Do you sit on the ball and run it because you have enough of a lead? Or do you try and extend it because you always feel like the other team can come back?
Extend it. Have some fun.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Back to throw again. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is a defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
They'll look to throw again. And he gets this to the 48, but no further. Well short of the line to gain. Back to throw here. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And the Giants are going to take possession of the football. Now with that interception, you feel like we got a ball game again. Remember, two-score contest and still time left here in the fourth.
And in the old days, not too long gone either, throwing the ball here would have been an absolute no-no. But the way the game's played now, throwing it makes sense. You just have to be careful when you put it in the air.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone, toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. And they're moving on to the conference championship. How about this?
What a tremendous feeling to get to the game that can get you to the Super Bowl. A fantastic season. Unfortunately, for the other team, a tough, tough way for it to end.